Hello, it's Silje, and I hope you all are having a wonderful day. Today I will do a haul, and I haven't been doing a haul since early July, I think. So it's long overdue because I have bought some books this fall. The first pile of books that I will show you, I bought in Stavanger. I went to Stavanger last month. And among other things, I visited this used bookshop. And I am a collector of a series called Lanterne. It is a Norwegian series from the late 50s to the early 80s. And every time I visit a used bookshop, I look for them and I buy them. And this time around, I found four. And I found Tarjei Vesaas, who is my favorite author, or one of them. He wrote The Seed, which is my favorite by him, but also The Ice Palace and The Birds. And I am mostly familiar with his novels, but this is a collection of his short stories. And among other stories, some of my favorites are here as well. So I was really pleased to find that one. I also found another Norwegian modern classic, and that is Jens Bjørneboe. And his books meant the world to me when I was 17, 18, 19, especially his geology, the history of bestiality. This is three books about humanity and also the nature of evil. So I found the two books in this trilogy. I have all of them in another edition, but this is my favorite. It's The Moment of Freedom, and this is the last one, The Silence. And I also found a book called Hertug Hans, or Count Hans. I'm not sure if this has been translated, but I really like the 70s designed on all of these three. A book that I have been impatiently awaiting is Hey Bert by Roberto Pastore, and he is the husband of Sean at Shani Reads, or she has changed the channel name to, I will leave it down there. Right now I'm blanking out. But this is his poetry collection. And I was planning on reading it back to back last weekend, but I am not that kind of poetry reader. I need to dip in and out of the collection. So I had read the two first ones, and they are completely different from what I'm usually reading. I am this dark, angsty poetry reader, and this is the complete opposite so far. But his poetry, or his poems, fills me with warmth and wonder and light and joy. And it makes me so happy reading them, and I can't wait to read some more. It is fantastic. And speaking of Sean, I have a book that I ordered thanks to her. And that is High School by Tegan and Sara. And Tegan and Sara are musicians and twins from Canada. They're also known as LGBTQ plus icons. And this is their memoirs from their high school days. And I have already not read it, but I have listened to it on audio. And it's great. It's really, really great. And I will talk more about it in a wrap-up. But I am so glad that I also have it in physical form now, because in the audio you get footage from gigs and practices, and in this one you get pictures. Let's see if I can find any pictures now. Tegan and Sara. Then I have a book that has made me scratch my head for the last 5 days. And this is a book that was on my most anticipated books of the year list. And it was a book that I was planning on ordering. And on Wednesday, I got a package in the mail. And it turns out it was Patti Smith's Year of the Monkey. And I got so happy, but at the same time so confused, because I didn't recall ordering this at all. And I usually recall ordering it, I know when I bought it, and why, and where. And I was blanking out, I couldn't recall anything. And I went through my account at the bookshop, and I didn't find anything there. I searched through my emails, and I couldn't find anything there either. But as it turns out, this is the monthly book from Angelica. And I am so, so glad that she sent it to me. I am so eager to read it. It will go straight to my pile of possibilities for nonfiction November. And I am also very glad that I'm not losing my mind. The next pile of books that I got are a pile of horror books. The three first ones are comics or graphic novels, and I found all three of them through Travis or Oddfellow Thoughts channel. The first one is A Walk Through Hell by Garth, Ennis and Goran Sudzuka. This is about two FBI agents who gets a call to get to this warehouse. That's why the volume is called Warehouse. They do think this is more of a routine case, but when they enter the warehouse, they realize that that is definitely not the case. Then I have volume 1 and volume 2 of a series called Evolution. Evolution volume 1, Origins of a Species, I bought in Paris, and then I bought volume 2. And I'm so glad I did, because I read the first volume last night, and I'm so happy that I can just continuing on with the story. This is about evolution, and evolution speeding up very, very quick. So the humans are changing at this rapid pace. It says on the back, human evolution has taken millions of years to get to this stage, but next week we become something new. Around the world, humanity is undergoing rapid and unpredictable changes, and only three individuals seem to notice that their world is being reborn. But what can they do about it? And this is definitely horror. It is body horror, because the changes happen so fast that everything changes, and it's very gruesome and gory, but the story is so well done. It's very intriguing and mysterious, and I can't wait to dive into volume 2. There's also a cult. I mean, come on, I like cults. Another book that is body horror is Wilder Girls by Rory Power. And this is, I think, YA, but I'm not sure. And the reason why I bought this is because Miriam at Betweenlinesandlife has been talking about it, and she did a review, and I got curious, and I wanted to take part in the conversation. So here I am. And this is a book that I'm currently reading, and I'm enjoying it a lot. It's set to this island at this school for girls, and the whole island has been put under quarantine due to a disease called the Tox. And the Tox can kill you, but it will definitely change you. We are following three young women. And one day, one of them runs out of the school grounds, and her friend Hetty runs after her, trying to find her. And it's not only the humans that are changing due to the tox, also the nature is changing. And I haven't gotten very far in, but even at this page, there has happened some really disturbing things, and I've heard it is pretty gruesome, so I can't wait. And just let us take a moment and look at this gorgeous cover. A completely random buy is this book. It's called The Raw Shark Texts by Stephen Hall, and I haven't heard about the author nor the novel, but it's about a man who wakes up and he doesn't recall anything. He doesn't know who he is. The only thing he has is some journal entries. And it says it's a thrilling adventure that will send Eric and his cynical cat Ian on a search for the Ludovician, the force that is threatening his life. It's a cat. A cat called Ian, who is cynical. Of course, I want to read it. It's also been compared to Donnie Darko and Memento. In September, I finished Nevernight by J. Kristoff, so of course I had to get the two other books in this series. And speaking of fantasy, I got Red Sister by Mark Lawrence. This was brought to my attention by Elisabeth at Bookish North. This is said to be very fast-paced and very, very plot-driven, and I will save this to a day when I need that. It's about this convent of nuns who teaches young girls to become killers. The main character is Nonna Grey. She is 8 years old and she is accused of murder, but she has done worse. And curious. Then I have a YA contemporary called Summer of Salt. This takes place on an island during a summer. We meet two sisters. There are some magical elements. And it's about sisterhood. It's about sexuality. And also heavy topics like sexual assault and also rape. So that might be the reason why I picked this one up. But I've heard good things about it. And also, one science fiction book called Do You Dream of Terra 2 by Temi Oh. This is debut, and I first heard about it on Marc Nash's channel. And this is about a group of 10 astronauts that are leaving everything behind to get to Terra 2, which is a planet very similar to planet Earth. For them are veterans from the space race, and 6 of them are teenagers who have been trained their whole life for this expedition. And it says it will take the team 23 years to reach Terra 2. 23 years locked in close quarters. 23 years with no one to rely on but each other. 23 years with no rescue possible should something go wrong. And something always goes wrong. And that was most of the books that I have acquired for the last 3 months. Not all of them, but most of them. And yeah, if you have read any of them, please let me know what you thought. Did you like them? Did you hate them? Were you like, meh? Please let me know in the comments. And yeah, thank you so much for watching. And until next time, ha det!